before we do anything, I want to give a quick shout out to my latest Patreon supporter, Coburn64. Thank you very much, man. I greatly appreciate the support.
Did you just assume my gender?
I did conduct a poll on Discord about which video topic to discuss, and everyone that voted wanted me to do a shooting mechanic in Unity, CryEngine, and Unreal Engine. However, due to circumstances of real life, I was not able to finish that script for this week, so we will be doing another topic today. Hello, I'm Jesco, you're watching Game Dev Made Easy, and today we are going to discuss how to install Python 3 in Visual Studio Community Edition 2017 on Windows, and how to get started with PyGame. Now, before we get started with this, I want to preface that Python is not a language I typically use for a myriad of reasons, but the reason why Python is a great choice of a language to use is due to the fact that rapid prototyping is possible with the language. When you add PyGame to the mix, which in its own rights has become a popular game development tool, you can prototype out different game mechanics and create a proof of concept any game development projects you are working on. This is not to say that you can't prototype and build a full game in PyGame with Python, as that is something you can most certainly do. For those of us that use C# with Unity or CryEngine, or C++ with CryEngine or Unreal Engine, we know the pains of trying to prototype and build a proof of concept with these engines, and Python and PyGame can most assuredly ease those pains significantly. PyGame is a 2D game library that is truly portable. You can build games for just about everything that you can think of, as long as there is support for it. It was built on top of the SDL library, it has multi-core CPUs in mind, has optimized C and assembly code for core functions, works with multiple graphics backends, and is very easy to use. With the wall of text finally taken care of, let's actually get started with installing Python in PyGame. The first thing you want to do is open the Visual Studio Installer application. And if you're like me and need to update the Visual Studio Installer, go ahead and take care of those updates.
1 eternity later.
Alright, we are back and now we can continue on with this. With your installation of Visual Studio, click on Modify. With Workloads, scroll down a little and locate Python Development. For installing everything, it will take up about 4.5 gigs of space. But the only things you absolutely need are the cookie cutter template support, Python web support, and Python 3 64-bit or Python 3 32-bit. Once those have been installed, we can continue on. Open up Visual Studio Community Edition 2017. Click on File, New, and Project. If you navigate to the Python folder in the project window, you will notice many different templates to choose from, and only one of them offers PyGame, but that is with PyConnect. So instead, click on Python application as a type and click OK. Click on View and scroll down to other windows to show more window options. Locate and click on Python environments. Just under Python 3.6 64-bit, you should see Overview. Click on it and switch to Packages, PyPI, or PyPI. Just underneath the packages PyPI, there is a text box. Click on that and type PyGame inside of it. In the output window, it will show you that it has downloaded PyGame and installed it. Switch over from Python environments in the Solution Explorer. Click inside and you will see Python environments added to the Python application in the solution. Click on Python 3.6 and it will reveal pip, PyGame, and setup tools. We now have Python and PyGame installed. Now we can have some fun and create a little demo application to make sure everything works appropriately. It is extremely important to remember that Python is whitespace and tab sensitive. This is part of the reason why I don't like to use Python often, as it goes against what I am used to with C#, C++, C, F#, and assembly. To preface this, when I was making this simple example we are about to go over, I made the mistake of not correctly tabbing and caused unnecessary havoc to debug and fix. The very first thing to do is import PyGame. This is to actually gain access to the PyGame library and to be able to call functions made available to us. Next up is to write pygame.init. This initializes the PyGame modules that will allow it to run appropriately. We need to now define the width and height of our window. To do this, write dwidth and set the value to be 800. This will define the width of the window that we will create to be 800. Write dheight and set the value to be 600. This will define the height of the window to be 600. Now we have the width and height as 800 by 600 resolution. We can now use these values to set the actual display window size to be this resolution. To do this, type game display is set to pygame.display.set_mode with the parameters of dwidth and dheight. With every application in game, it normally has text with it that says the name of that program. We can do this with PyGame as well. Type pygame.display.set_caption with the parameter being a string value of game dev made easy tutorial. This will set the window's name to be whatever the string value is. Now, we need to define the image that we want to be displayed on screen. And since I'm a bit egotistical, I have set the convention to be my logo, we will continue with that. Write GDME logo, and it will be set to pygame.image.load. It will have the value of justcode.png. Now we need to define the logo itself as it will be an image displayed on the screen. Write DEF logo with the parameters of X and Y and put a colon after it. This should automatically indent the next line. If it doesn't, press the tab key one time, which should put the cursor to be lined up with the L in logo. Write gameDisplay.blit with the parameters of GDME logo, comma, with X and Y in another set of parentheses. Blit allows you to draw one image into another, and it is considered a surface in PyGame. A surface is a PyGame object for representing images. This next part is extremely important. Make sure you are no longer indented with the next set of items we write. If you are indented, then Python will think that everything that is indented is part of the definition for logo, and you will have the application throw errors every time you test the program. We will define what the X and Y values will be next. X should be set to 150. Y should be set to 50. This will put the image to be roughly in the center of the screen. We now want to create a Boolean value with the name of ended, and it should be set to false. We will be using this as a means of exiting a while loop. And speaking of that while loop, let's go ahead and create it. To do this, write while, not ended, with a colon. This is our main game loop. You should again be indented. We need to create a for loop at this point. This for loop will be as followed. For event in pygame.event.get. This checks to see which events have been called and how to handle certain events. Write if event.type is equal to pygame.quit with a colon. Ended is now set to true. This will exit the while loop upon ended being changed from false to true. Make sure your indent is lined up with the for loop for this next line. Write logo with the parameters of x, y. This will draw the logo onto the screen. And with any game, we need an update loop. So write pygame.display.update. This will update the display every frame. For the next part, remove all indenting. Write pygame.quit. This calls the quit sequence to exit and deinitialize the PyGame module. Write quit. This will exit the Python application environment itself. The very last thing is to add the image into Visual Studio. So add either my logo or any other image by right-clicking in the Python application in the Solution Explorer. Highlight Add and then click on Existing Item. Make sure you change from just Python files to all files and locate the image you want to use. Click OK after you've selected the image you want and the image will be imported into the solution. press the play button, which should have the word attached next to it in Visual Studio. This will call the Python runtime environment, and it will launch PyGame. As we can see, we have an 800 by 600 resolution window with the phrase Game Dev Made Easy Tutorial as the Windows title, and it has the Game Dev Made Easy logo in the center of the screen. You can also see that the total amount of code utilized was very minimal, so rapid prototyping is very possible using PyGame and Python. As stated before, using Python and PyGame is very good for testing and prototype, even if you mainly use a 3D engine, this can be useful. For example, if you are working on testing out new algorithms for creating something, conversion from 2D to 3D is very simple, and you can use this sort of environment to test how they would run and perform. This has been Jessica with Game Dev Made Easy, and remember, use every tool you can, and always strive to learn something new. You never know when it may become useful for you. You're still here? There's nothing else here for you to see. Well, since you're still here, I have multiple social media websites that you can follow me on, such as Twitter, Quora, Minds, or even Gab. Well, go on, shoo. Click on one of the videos in the screen for a choice of what you could watch next. And you are most welcome to bug me on social media or Discord.